Hey guys, I'm Sandra Matos. Welcome to IO2. Get ready to be overloaded with news. First up, the inventor of the operation game can't afford his own real life operation. Is it okay to laugh?
Yeah, laugh. It's kind of funny.
Do you remember the game Operation? John Spinello earned some money and a spot in pop culture history 50 years ago when he invented the game Operation. It's a battery-powered game which lets kids play surgeon. I loved that game as a kid. My favorite part was trying to take out the wishbone. But now, at the age of 77, he needs $25,000 in oral surgery, and he can't afford it because he sold his rights to his creation for only $500. Ooh. Even so, Spinello says that he is not bitter and doesn't want to focus on his healthcare crisis. I'd be bitter. He should come up with Operation 2, the oral edition. Next up, a new parachute record is made. Okay, so who cares about a parachute record? Well, what if I tell you that the jump was made from the edge of space? Google boss 57-year-old Alan Eustace broke Felix Baumgartner's parachute record in a 135,000-foot jump from the edge of space. It's the highest parachute jump in history. The 3-year project was kept secret until now. Alan was wearing a specially designed spacesuit. He was lifted by a balloon filled with 35,000 cubic feet of helium. It took 15 minutes to descend after using explosives to separate him from the balloon. And once he was separated, he fell faster than the speed of sound. He returned to Earth just 15 minutes after his fall. How amazing! And now, what the hell is going on in high schools? In Washington, two 14-year-old girls are fighting for their lives. Gia Soriano and Shaylee Chuklanuskit are in critical condition after their friend shot them in the high school cafeteria. When the girls were targeted, the cafeteria was full of students. Aside from the two girls, another student was shot and killed, and two more were injured. This happened at the Marysville Pulchik High School. Why did this happen? All we know is that he was feeling really heartbroken over a girl. I'm assuming that one of the girls targeted was the girl he was feeling heartbroken over. The shooter did happen to tell a friend that he was feeling this way, that he was heartbroken and didn't know what to do. And as far as his name goes, I'm sorry I'm not giving him the satisfaction of saying his name, but the shooter did, after, turn on himself and killed himself. Let's all send the families of these victims our thoughts and prayers. And there you have it. That's what's going on in the news. I'm Sandra Matos. Thanks for watching. And if you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more videos.